Next up, he's 29 years old, coming through from the state of Illinois, Kelly.
The challenges that I encountered, really, with Buckeye were not that bad. I think with him being turned out for a couple years probably helped rather than just a horse that was fresh off the track. He had mellowed out a lot. The first couple weeks were definitely hard just because he hadn't had a consistent, you're going to get tied up every day or, you know, it just consistency. He hadn't had that for a long time. So kind of once we brushed the rust off, he settled in. He got treated for, you know, a few issues that he had. He had bad feet and stuff like that. So, I mean, we had some work to do. But after that, he settled in and got right to work, and he's been very, very willing. Kelly is showing us the left leg and the right leg yields right now, moving through her transitions very easily. Kelly's now going to side pass both ways on the log. Demonstrating incredible control over this animal that, remember, has only been in training for roughly 100 days. Standing still for a minimum of 5 seconds, showing how much control she has over this horse. Kelly is accomplishing all of this with a very, very light rein. Now I believe she's going to run a pole pattern, which is very, very intricate. This is quite a challenge to undertake for a thoroughbred. Fantastic movement. Fantastic control. She is just doing an incredible job with this horse. For a horse of that size and speed to be able to do that, that's a very impressive. Impressive run. Now she's going to calm him back down. Dragging a bridge with him. Not one of the required movements, but part of the wow factor for sure, folks. You have to remember that this is a thoroughbred that was off of the racetrack no more than approximately 100 days ago. She's going bridleless now. Absolutely incredible. Outstanding control. Oh my, here we go. She's standing up on him and she's going to crack the whip. Oh my. Wow, boy, is she setting a precedent with this.
she's giving them all something to shoot for.
Nicole Valerie is one of our youngest competitors at the age of 20.
She's bringing the wow factor from the get-go, gang. Well, if this doesn't show how much training she's put into this horse, nothing does. To be shooting off of his back at 100 days. He's completely ineffective. Jumping fire too. Not a problem. Again, I'm going to go back to there, how soft and supple her hands are, how light she's touching those reins, showing us her transitions. Left leg yield. The way he bent at the pole. Right leg yield, he's just flowing across the arena.
I'd like to think that my chances for the competition are pretty good. My horse is really working well and he has a lot of heart and try. But either way, I've already won because I've grown tremendously as a horse person and I've know I've been able to help this horse get a better life.
Very nice stop. One-handed, look how light he is in the mouth. That takes a lot of practice. Yes. Very nice stop. Very supple. Let him relax a second. Our forehand spins. Very nice. Now on a side note, Nicole did win the barrel race on this horse last night. So she is leading the barrel racing. A little bit of movement on the pole, doing the side passes, but he didn't get excited about it. She kept him under control, kept him within her hands. Very nice backup, very proper, correct, straight. Way more than the required four steps. You see how easy she's doing that with her hands. These trainers have been very impressive this evening, performing their maneuvers and bringing the wow factor for sure.
This young man saw it on the field and playing it hot. And the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle
he's
player.
He's even doing
too.
Her leg yield with and the piano. Counteracting him. He's just now doing basically whatever she's asking of him. He's doing. Look at that counterarc. Very impressive. Nicole has put the time in. It's proxy evidence. Her and Rings are definitely a team. We've been a relationship established here. He's not just another horse, I don't believe, to Nicole.
He opened up his case and he said, I'll start this show. fire flew from his fingertips as he rolled up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings.
She's showing you there how she's backing him completely with her hips. Now she's probably impressive.
Sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You,
well, Jimbo, it's about 95 degrees tonight here in a sweatshirt and boxing gloves, so I have to give you props just for that.
They keep moving forward. How much you take, they keep moving forward.
Rocky theme song, you have to love it. Eye of the tiger, hold one eye, warrior horse, nice leg yield, very nice leg yield. You can tell Jimbo's going to make this very entertaining. I'm not sure what it would be like to ride with boxing gloves on. Can't imagine it's easy, but he's still making it look incredibly easy. His horse is completely unaffected by the crowd. Even if Jimbo only nicely changed. Quite as pretty, but again, a nice lead change. And Jimbo begging for yelling from the crowd. How can you not cheer for a character such as this? He's bringing the wow factor, folks. Very nice backup. Very nice backup. Very straight, correct. Way more than the required four steps. He's going for the stand-up. Oh, and showing boxing moves. This is very impressive. I'm off track there, but... Jimbo is obviously putting in a lot of time with this horse, as all the trainers have. Forehand turn. Going right into the side passes. Saying I don't need that log to side pass. I can side pass behind it. Who needs a log? There, I'll side pass now.
We found Gene. Generation Speed is his name. We found him through, actually, the Ultimate X Showdown Facebook page. You know, at first, he sounded good. She said he would probably fit the competition just perfect. And then she mentioned he had one eye. But the more I talked to Beth, the more she described to me just what this horse had on the inside. But, you know, forget about what's on the outside, his appearance. He had what it took, I think, to be very competitive in the Ultimate X Showdown.
Starting out with the wow factor. Oh my. Beautiful. He is refusing, but she's working with him and keeping him between the reins and her legs. She's working on him. trainers know how to handle these horses. Quite incredible. You can tell that he's very, very edgy, that she's doing everything she can to assure him that it's all good. Just look at this. Very nice. His stop.
My expectations are for him to do as good as he can do. He's brilliant, and I just hope that he shines through more so than anything, because he knows what he's doing. It's just, if everything goes right, he'll do good. It's just going to be what the setting is and how he handles everything. I plan to go on with him after this and make him my intercollegiate rodeo horse for the barrels, and possibly, if he's good enough, get my pro card on him.
Dakota trying to get calm down and into her hands.
On the park bench, an old man was sitting there.
Nice back. Very nice
back. I said,
back.
The old courthouse is kind of run down. He said, no, it'll do for our little town. I said, the old flagpole is leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it. He said, have a seat. And I sat down. Is this the first time you've been to our little town? I said, I think it is. He said,
very
I don't
nice
like
side
to
pass.
Brag, but we're kind of proud.
He's keeping him focused on her.
You see, we got a little hole in
that
flag
there.
Incredible
job of keeping him focused
on her.
When
Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key said, watching it right and say, can you see? And it got a bad rip in New Orleans.
Packing him and Jackson tugging at its seams. Very impressive, dear. Very impressive.
It almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on.
You can certainly not go wrong with a tribute to Old Glory.
She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville. And she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg
out there under saddle.
And the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag.
Yielding its pole.
On Flanders Field
again,
in World War I,
his attention.
She got a big hole from a birth ago. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp.
She is just doing a very admirable job of keeping him focused on her.
She was in Korea, Vietnam.
His nerves.
She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, disarmed, denied, refused.
Again, another very,
and the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare, and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape.
Put his trust in her.
She's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a
whole lot. She really has gotten him calmed down very nicely.
So we raise her up every morning. We take her down every night. We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Thank you, Dakota.
Thank you.
Very, very heartwarming.
Nikki Edges is 23 years old and from the state of California.
Oh, very nice, Nikki, bringing the Kansas, California flag. got him all ready to walk and calm down. Very nice. Great job, Gaker. Let's get her stop and get her back on. See if she can get him calmed back down a little bit and under control a little bit more this time and perform some of her maneuvers. Nikki's here all the way from the state of California, so there's no question in her training ability. She's having a little bit of a rough go at this, which can sometimes happen with these young off-track thoroughbreds. Any of them can be a little frisky on any given day. But she's going to persevere.
What made me unique was the fact that I never really started horses that were just easy and by the textbook. I had to pick a nice horse, bring it home, find out why it was in the kill pens in the first place, pick it apart, untrain it, retrain it, and make it into something new, which is kind of how you do the race horses. You untrain them and then you retrain them. So it kind of fits our program really good. I was looking for an older, more war horse type since that's what I've had a lot of success with in the past. Came across this cute little bay gelding. He's 4 years old, 15-3, nice build, nice breeding, sound. He just kept catching my eye, so finally I find out that he's only 15 minutes from my ranch. Went and looked at him, took me about 5 minutes to decide that was the one we were going to take home. One of the challenges with retraining him was just that he was a little argumentative, a little studdish since he was a late cut. He's a little cocky, but once he learns a pattern, he really gets it down. So sometimes that cocky and overconfidence plays in really well down the road once he's got a pattern in his head.
Nikki is trying to get him calmed down. He is paying nice attention to her now. She's a true cowgirl. There's no quitting this girl. Her leg yields now. Left and right leg yields. Side passing. She's continually trying to reassure him and keep him calm and trying to get him to focus more on her than the crowd. Makes me feel alive. Very nice with the flag again.
Hold your applause, please. Horse heading out the door.
Next up, 32-year-old young lady from North Carolina, I'll talk Alicia. Her chosen off the track girlfriend is Odie.
Alicia is got the costume rockin'. Beautiful leg yield. Fighting her just a little bit, but she's working it. Trying to keep those hands soft and supple. Keep his head between her hands and her legs. This is another horse that's only a 4-year-old, as I'm seeing. Aptly named, I am the big dog. Yes, you are. Alicia is showing nice control here with him. Very nice control. Very nice stop and back. Again, more than the 4 strides required. Very pretty. Stop for 5 seconds and stand, letting him relax, giving him reassurance. Giving her a forehand and rear turns. Again, he's a little bit edgy, but she's doing a commendable job of keeping him within her grasp. And again, keeping a nice, easy pressure on the reins. Again, light hands. It's been very nice to see that from these trainers.
Oki is a registered thoroughbred. He is 18 hands tall and about 1,500 pounds, and he just turned 4. His registered name is I Am the Big Dog, and he is almost a world record thoroughbred as far as height. Challenges I had, initially he came in very poor condition because he had been in the kill barn. We had to put 300 plus pounds on him. He had never had his teeth done. His feet were in horrible condition. He was lame. Then he came up with an abscess in his back left foot. He got 42 days of stall rest. He was 3-legged, so I lost 42 days of training. I've just been working on getting him really solid, getting his foundation solid, getting his maneuvers down. He's still a little slow as far as turning the barrels, but in my opinion, just saving him from the meat killer and giving him a career was we won then.
Very nice leg yields. Thank you.
Did anybody else see that coming? All right, ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause?